Hey everyone, Cody here, and today we're going to be looking at the question, what is it meant by abstract painting? So what does it mean? You know, what does abstract painting mean, and, or why does it exist? Well, essentially, if you look at what abstract painting means, if you abstract something, it means you're kind of either simplifying it or distilling that down. So abstraction generally is the process of kind of breaking something down. And if you look at what painting means and what abstract painting means, it means you're breaking something that is more complex into something more simple. And this is exactly what the founding, you know, artists, mostly we call them the founding fathers of abstract, were doing when they started creating abstract paintings. You know, they took these, you know, naturalistic or realistic paintings, and instead of representing what we normally see in nature or in life, which is what most paintings used to be, we now created these paintings where we took those and abstracted them down to simplified lines or colors or shapes. And they can still represent the same things, but they're not visually represented in the way that we used to be able to see them. And this is why a lot of old paintings were just paintings of landscapes or people or depictions of events, because we were representing what we actually saw in real life. But now abstraction is kind of the process of taking what we normally see and distilling it down to simplified, again, shapes, lines, colors, things like that. That's what is meant by abstract painting, where you're taking kind of what is seen and breaking it down to simplified forms. And instead of, you know, representing exactly what you see like a photograph would, you're now representing it in a way that it's more left open to interpretation, and also just in a way that might express more of what that, how that artist feels about that situation, as opposed to just re-representing what you used to see. And I think that thinking about it just kind of occurred to me that abstraction is actually kind of important, because if you think about it, back years ago, you know, let's say 100, 200, 300 years ago and beyond, right? Before the invention of the camera, where the camera would actually record what was going on, before the invention of the camera, really, artists had no other way except through sculptures and paintings and drawings to represent what was actually seen in the world. So paintings actually make a lot of sense back in the day to create naturalistic or realist paintings and to try to represent what you saw in everyday life in the form of a painting. But now if you think about it, we don't need that anymore. In fact, you know, video cameras and cameras in general have created the ability for us to take a snapshot of life, or, you know, record a section of life and put that out into the world, or to have with us at all times. And we can do this at any time we want. So, and with the evolution of the internet on top of all that, we can now look at pictures of another place that we've never even been to and know exactly what it's like. But, you know, 200, 300, thousands of years ago, we didn't have that. We had only paintings and sculptures and drawings. And so people tried to represent what they saw in those pictures. But now that we have photographs and cameras and, you know, video recordings, we no longer need that. We can see the representation of life because all we have to do is go online or look around us and take a picture of it and show that to other people. So there's no longer a need necessarily for naturalistic or even realist paintings. Now, I'm not saying that people shouldn't do them, because there are some really amazing hyper-realist artists out there. My only point is that abstract makes sense nowadays because we no longer need photographs to represent what's going on in our life. We simply take a picture and we store it on a file or print it out into a picture, and we have that representation there, and we can be remembered, you know, we can be reminded of that thing just by looking at that photograph. We don't need that as much anymore. So now abstract kind of fits in with our daily life because we have photographs to remind us of what's going on in the world, or we have video, and now we have abstract. So that's basically more about representing how an artist feels, or distilling something down into its simplest form. So that is what it's meant by that. That's why abstract even exists. And that's why it's also kind of important, because it's no longer about trying to represent the things that are going on in the world, because now we have photographs and videos to do that. So that's it for that video. I will catch you guys in the next one. If you like it, please subscribe and let me know what other topics you'd like me to talk about. But that's it. I will see you guys in the next one. Take care. Bye.